professional opinion, can you summarize for this board, and if you can't, it's okay, the major changes that occurred and were agreed to between Mr. Gordon and Mr. Hunzinger without the presumed knowledge of the city commission between the signing of the power purchase agreement on May 29th of 09 and the consent and agreement, which actually changed the PPA on June 30th of 2011?
I'd rather have the city attorney or somebody from that legal perspective answer that question.
Okay, and that's great. And so I think that's really one of the major, major issues when I talk to folks out there.
Yes.
About what's going on. And as I understand the statute of limitations, the statute of limitations for us actually challenging anything is 4 years, is that correct?
Well, I know that the statute of limitation has run out on the power purchase agreement as well as the equitable adjustment. And I guess there's still time left on the clock on the consent and agreement.
So let's review that. So 4 years from the signing of the PPA would be 4 years from 09. So that's
correct.
Expired.
Correct.
4 years from the equitable adjustment would be from 11.
Yeah, 2011.
The consent agreement was signed on June 30th of 11, so 4 years would have passed, but in fact, the 4 years hasn't passed because the city commission didn't discover the consent agreement until late in 2013.
Okay.
So 4 years from late in 2013 would be actually the end of this year.
Correct.
So okay. The end of 2017. Now, you've discussed that it is your intention to have this wrapped up by the end of November. And I would argue that if, in fact, it's not wrapped up by the end of November, that statute of limitations is going to pass, and then there's no going back from when we discovered that very important document that changed the power purchase agreement. Would you agree?
I hear what you're saying.
As far as the four-year term.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know what any action on the consent and agreement would do. I mean, I'm not a lawyer. I would certainly revert back to the city attorney in that regard. But it's certainly the elements of the consent and agreement don't abrogate or void the contract. It would void elements, other elements, that may be less beneficial than what we're doing right now.
Which is why we have the arbitration. So let's talk a little bit about the arbitration. You kind of discussed some of the reasons for the arbitration. And so far to date, has anything been discovered that would benefit the city in the arbitration?
I'm sorry, we talked about the $9 million that we're looking at as a possible claim. Well, it actually is a claim in the arbitration itself. We have the various items that we've retained or withheld, so that's $7.4 million there. There's several different arguments about availability. Is that what you mean?
That is, and I guess really what I'm looking at, though, is there any chance through the arbitration that GRU could actually get a declaratory judgment that would prove that there was a material breach to the power purchase agreement, which was modified by the consent agreement, which would render the power purchase agreement voidable?
That is one of the remedies that we've asked for.
So is it possible that if we win that would occur?
There's always a possibility.
Okay, great. I like possibilities. So if possible, and if discovery continued, would that maybe achieve a different negotiating position for you and Mr. Gordon?
As I've said in my other meetings, if ifs and nuts were candies and nuts, what a Merry Christmas we'd have.
Okay, well, for me, though, that's kind of a huge point. I mean, ultimately, under the best-case scenario of the arbitration, the city could win, receive a judgment that would allow for the cancellation or modification of the power purchase agreement, which you said is basically this whole deal. The whole deal, the whole $750 million, is ultimately tied to the power purchase agreement.
Well, let me address that. I mean, I appreciate you bringing this up and bringing it to the light of day. One of the things you have to do in a particular case like this is if you have various options, you assign probabilities with that. So what would the probability be to abrogate the contract? I mean, it's you know.
I don't know. I said our attorney said 90-10. You said everything's 50-50.
To abrogate the contract.
Well, I mean, I don't know. That's a great question. What is the probability?
Well, I would think that it would be considerably, since we are limited to arbitration within the power purchase agreement, that, you know, it's not likely that many arbiters decide that tend to be split the baby kind of individuals. It tends to be the nature of the beast, if you will. So let's assume that there was a way to save $2.1 billion by abrogating the contract. 10% possibility of that. Well, that's a resultant expectation of $210 million. Then you would look at the 90% certainty of not saving the other. So you would be at a loss. So you would have to be somewhere probably around 30, 40, 50% probability of abrogating the contract before you would actually go down that road.